In this part, we'll talk about some more special modifications of adventitious roots. The next one, two we have already discussed. One was assimilatory and the other was for storage. Here we are talking of epiphytic roots. Epiphytic roots are found in epiphytes and they are also known as hygroscopic roots. Hygroscopic because they are able to absorb humidity. That means they absorb moisture from the atmosphere. Now, why should they or why do they need to absorb this moisture? The reason is the plants where we find these roots, they are epiphytes. So, what exactly are epiphytes? Epiphytes are plants that grow on the branches of tall trees. Now, normally these epiphytes are found in evergreen forests, and in evergreen forests, the canopy is very thick. Canopy means the upper part of the tree, which is green. So, if the canopy is thick, very, very less light falls on the ground. So how would this plant get light? This plant is a very small plant. So these epiphytes, they grow on the branches of tall trees so that they are able to reach up to the sunlight. And now, because they are on the branches of tall trees, in other words, we can say they are away from soil. So if they are not in the soil or not attached to the soil, then how can they absorb water from soil? So they need to absorb this atmospheric moisture, which we call humidity. For that, they have special type of roots, and in their roots, there is a special tissue which is known as velamen tissue. Velamen tissue is the one which helps the roots absorb this moisture. The example where we find these epiphytic roots are all the epiphytes like orchids, vanda. So here the epiphytic roots are present, and we now know what epiphytes are. They are growing on the tall trees. They are not parasites. They are autotrophs. They perform their own photosynthesis. Only thing is they are growing on the branch of a tall tree to get sunlight because of the thick canopy in the forest. But when it is away from soil, it has this modification to absorb water, and that is from the atmosphere. The next modification, again a special type of adventitious root, are known as climbing roots. As the name tells us, these roots would help the plant climb. So here the stem is not that strong to hold the plant upright. So there would be some structure required for the plant to climb up the support. Example is pothos. Pothos is money plant. Or piper beetle. Piper beetle is another plant where we find these kind of roots. Now, how are these roots? When we see money plant, the stem is delicate and slender, and there are distinct nodes and internodes which are visible. So on one node we find a leaf growing, and on the other side there is a slender structure. At other node again there is a leaf growing and a slender structure. These slender structures, they are actually climbing roots, and if we observe it on the support, these structures help the stem to cling to that support. If we enlarge this part, then we would find that there are small hook-like structures at the lower side, and these are known as the root hooks. So root hook is also a modification of adventitious root, and these climbing roots are also modifications of adventitious root. Why are we calling them adventitious? Because they are arising from the stem, and climbing because they help the plant to climb. The next modification, parasitic roots. Parasitic roots. Parasitic roots are also known as haustoria. And the example that we take here is of cuscuta. It is a parasitic plant. Parasitic means it is dependent on the host for food and water. So if this is the host plant and these are the structures or the roots of cuscuta plant. So this is the haustoria. So what exactly happens is when this haustorium penetrates into the host plant, the outer tissue remains outside, that is epidermis, cortex and everything is outside. Only the vascular tissue part penetrates. So this part in the center is the vascular tissue. And this vascular tissue penetrates up to the vascular tissue of the host plant. This is vascular tissue of host. So what exactly is penetrating into the host plant is the vascular tissue. And xylem and phloem are coming in contact with xylem and phloem of the host plant. So xylem of cuscuta absorbs or takes water from the xylem of host plant, and phloem of cuscuta takes food directly from the host phloem. That means there is a direct connection between the connective tissue of haustoria and the connective tissue of vascular tissue of haustoria and vascular tissue of the host plant, so that the food and water can be directly taken from xylem and phloem. So these modifications are of adventitious roots, and because they are performing some unique functions, we have given them all these names. We can add one more modification here, which we have already talked of, that is Heptera. So Heptera, because they help those assimilatory roots to stick to the surface, they can also be termed as clinging roots or Heptera itself. So Heptera is also one additional modification. We can add it as separate, or we can include it along with the assimilatory roots. So we have talked of all modifications of adventitious roots, mainly for mechanical support and then for all various special functions. Now in the next part, we will start with the buds.